If you're like me, you know that one of the greatest places to be is at home. The average American spends roughly 17 hours of their day at home, and yet many of us aren't doing all that we can to make sure that our homes are safe. And no, I'm not talking about deadbolt locks or security cameras. I'm talking about the health risks associated with our everyday home appliances. Now, typically we're motivated to upgrade to energy efficient appliances to save ourselves time and money, but what if it could save your life? I know, that sounds so dramatic, but it's not that far-fetched. And on this episode of Plugged In, I'm explaining why. Before we start, be sure to like and subscribe if you want to stay plugged in to clean energy topics. Now today we're talking about how electrifying your home is shockingly good for your health. I'm specifically focusing on heating and cooking appliances because if I tried to tackle everything, well, I'd be here all day and I'm sure you'd get bored. Now for years we've been living with appliances that are, for lack of better words, sneaky little pollution machines. And while electric appliances have grown in popularity, two-thirds of U.S. households are still burning some type of fuel to heat their homes, dry their clothes, and cook their food. 60% use gas, 15% use other fossil fuels like propane and kerosene, and 9% use wood. And these are called sources of combustion.
Tell me everything you know about this combustion device.
Which, by definition, just means burning something, but I don't know about you, when I hear the word combustion, I think... not something I want in my home or near my family members. But let's stay on track. We're focusing on the invisible dangers of combustion source appliances for heating and cooking. You see, these appliances are never 100% efficient, meaning they don't use all the energy they create, so the excess goes into the air where it can then make its way into our lungs, and in some cases, our bloodstream. And if you're relying on fossil fuel appliances, these pollutants can be harmful or even deadly. The information on this has been circulating for decades, yet so many Americans are unwilling to break up with natural gas. It's like a toxic relationship. And that's why for this episode, I've enlisted in the help of two researchers from the Behavioral Insights team.
Gina Murpuri, and I'm the head of sustainability at the Behavioral Insights team in the U.S.
And I'm Anna Kelleher. I'm a senior advisor at the Behavioral Insights team in the U.S.
And I'm hoping all the research we're about to share will help clear the air. Pun intended. Let's start with the most hotly debated appliance. The gas stove has stirred up a ton of controversy, from health concerns to environmental impact, and of course, a dose of politics. It always comes back to politics. But what is it about the gas stove in particular that has America in a tizzy? Well, likely boils down to the fact that the natural gas business has had quite an expert marketing plan for the stove.
Now you're cooking with gas.
Yeah, like that phrase, cooking with gas, which was coined by someone who worked in the gas industry back in the 1930s. He was well connected with entertainment professionals and actually got them to start writing it into scripts nearly 100 years later, and we're still saying it. But that was really just the beginning of advertising for natural gas.
Gas!
Your gas company brings you modern gas.
Modern gas to warm you, to cool you, to cook your meals.
Claudia Noble had a dream, but very little money. So she got some space, filled it with little girls, and heated it with gas.
Okay, so that last one maybe wasn't their biggest stroke of marketing genius, but all this advertising worked. If you're a chef, amateur or otherwise, I already know that trying to convince you to switch to an electric stove is a tough sell. Trust me, my mother's Italian. She swears by the gas stove. And when I talked to Sheena, even with her extensive career in sustainability, she told me that she's fallen victim to gas stove marketing.
I remember when my husband and I were looking for an apartment, and I wasn't around, my only requirement to him was in saying, it has to be a gas stove. It just has to be. I had this sense that they cook better, they perform better, the food comes out tasting better.
This is exactly what Big Gas wants us to believe. And their marketing campaign lives on even in 2025 through paid partnerships with chefs and influencers.
Yep.
If you think about it, even the name natural gas is a brilliant marketing move for a fossil fuel that's primarily made of methane. If we called it a methane stove, you'd probably think, dirty, toxic, I'm not cooking on that thing. But that is what you're cooking on, and it has harmful repercussions. When we cook with a gas stove, traces of carbon monoxide, methane, benzene, and nitrogen dioxide, or NO2, are sent into the air. Inhaling these toxins at high levels has been linked to various breathing issues. Nearly 13% of childhood asthma is attributed to gas stove use. But it's also been linked to other breathing issues, lung disease, leukemia, diabetes, decreased lung development in children, even early death, or at best, side effects like headaches, nausea, dizziness, and your ability to smell and taste. Wow, I sound like one of those medication commercials. Anyway, the gas stoves in our homes can emit pollution levels way higher than what is considered safe by the World Health Organization. It says we shouldn't exceed indoor NO2 emissions over 106 parts per billion, or ppb. Yet something as simple as boiling water on a gas stove releases a peak 184 ppb, baking a cake 230, and roasting meat nearly 300 ppb. Last year, a group of scientists tested air quality in 18 homes and apartments with gas stoves across the U.S., and they not only discovered high levels of toxins, but they found the pollution extended beyond the kitchen, into living rooms, and even bedrooms. And we even talked about gas leaks. Take it from Anna.
If you fully electrify your house, then you're also eliminating exposure to leaking gas lines into the house, which is more common than people realize as well.
She's right. In a completely separate study from last year, researchers visited over 480 homes across the US and Canada that use natural gas and collected indoor air samples when the gas stoves weren't even on. They found 99% of those air samples were polluted. But the craziest part, 4% of the homes they visited were experiencing a relatively large natural gas leak. And one of the leaks was so large, researchers had to emergency evacuate all tenants in a 4-unit apartment, yet none of the tenants reported being able to smell the gas leak.
Gas leak? Yeah, gas leak.
The gas industry conducted its own research on how gas stoves impact indoor air quality back in the 70s, which was meant to be featured in a national report on pollution, and they included their findings about air toxins in a draft version of the report, but it was suspiciously absent from the final publication. We're all aware about the harmful effects of gas, and why are so many of us unwilling to part with it? Sheena has a theory.
Gas stoves feel really proximal. You know, like you see the food being cooked well and the food tasting good. It's something you've used in the past. Harmful indoor air pollution is just sort of being locked in and doesn't have anywhere to go. There's not as much airflow. But you don't necessarily identify with that in the moment.
The positive news is you do have a choice, and there's a much healthier alternative. Switching from a gas stove to an electric induction stove reduces NO2 pollution by 56%, according to a 2024 study. Instead of burning fossil fuels, induction stoves work by having an electromagnetic field, or EMF, below the glass cooktop surface that transfers current directly to magnetic cookware. And if the term electromagnetic field has you reaching for your tinfoil hat, I can assure you, you don't need it. There's no evidence of negative health effects from induction stoves. The radiation levels are way too weak to have any impact on our DNA or health. And the EMFs are about the same as what's in a fluorescent light bulb. Now, for everyone who claims that electric stoves don't cook as well as natural gas ones, well, let me just tell you, it's 2025. Technology has improved. I'm talking to you, Mom. Listen up.
They're a lot better now. They cook really well now. And I think people just haven't had as much exposure to them.
Induction stoves on the market today are proving to be 90% more efficient than gas and traditional electric stoves. They can boil water in just 1.5 minutes, while gas stoves take roughly 6 minutes and electric cooktops over 7 minutes. Now, I've never worked in a professional kitchen, but I have watched a ton of Food Network competition shows. So I know how important an extra 5.5 minutes can be in the kitchen.
Get out!
You know what? We've spent a ton of time in the kitchen, but the gas stove is not the only culprit of indoor air pollution. How about home heating? Most of us need that. Look, I love a cozy fireplace as much as the next person, but pollution from wood burning can cause coughing, wheezing, asthma, heart issues, and a higher risk of lung cancer. But the majority of Americans who haven't electrified their homes are relying on, you guessed it,
gas
for heating. I don't think I need to rattle off any more of the harmful side effects of natural gas, so let's instead focus on the positive things that you can look forward to by upgrading to an electric heat source, like a heat pump. If you're not familiar, heat pumps are kind of like an air conditioner that can also run in reverse. In cooling mode, they suck up all of the hot air indoors, the humidity too, and pump it outside. And in heating mode, it goes in reverse, soaking up all the heat from outside your home, yes, even when it's cold outside, and moving it indoors. Not a single fossil fuel is released in the process, which is much better for your health.
Heat pumps can reduce people's exposure to leaking pollutants like carbon monoxide. They can also increase indoor air quality by adding air filtration.
Now, I could go into the same song and dance about replacing all of your other appliances, but I'm trying to prevent your eyes from glazing over. So I'll wrap it up with a nice little bow by sharing this 2024 study that found that swapping out fossil fuel heaters, water heaters, and clothes dryers with electric options would lead to 3,400 fewer premature deaths, 1,300 fewer hospital and ER visits, 220,000 fewer asthma attacks, and 670,000 less days of reduced activity or missed work. They say health is wealth, and this study also considered that. They found electrifying America's homes would equal $40 billion in health benefits every year. And that doesn't even touch on the cost-saving benefits that energy-efficient appliances provide.
So getting a heat pump or an electric stove, the impact is so much greater than things like turning out your lights every day or other things that people traditionally think of when they think about trying to save energy.
And if you're really trying to cut out costs, you could add solar panels. That way you're generating your own energy to power all of your new electric appliances. Okay, at this point, you may be feeling a bit overwhelmed, and that's valid. Most of us don't have the means to rid ourselves of all of our gas appliances and upgrade to electric in one fell swoop. Now, there are some local and national incentives available, at least there are as of today, but it can still be expensive. Just know that whole home electrification is a journey, and it starts with awareness of the issue.
Now we know!
And knowing is half the battle.
So if you made it this far, congratulations, you can check step one off the list. Step two can just be making a plan, which can save you a lot of money and stress down the road.
Most people have a story of a time when their HVAC system broke and it was the biggest crisis that they've dealt with in a very long time. Working with people to make a plan ahead of when that happens is so important, because when you're in crisis mode, you are actually more likely to default to what seems like the easiest option.
Now, it's great to start window shopping if you have an idea of the kind of appliances you want, but remember that going electric is about more than the appliances. You also want to find a reputable contractor who is well-versed in home electrification.
There's so much nuance around if you want to upgrade more things down the line or upgrade multiple appliances, having the appropriate electrical load, for example. And so having the right people in your corner in that journey is critical.
All right, that's all I've got for today. Many thanks to Sheena and Anna for sharing their wisdom. And if you have any questions about home electrification or another topic you want us to dive into, drop a comment below and stay plugged in.